Hey, what's up, guys? We're going to be looking at my Astro Tailwind project that I've been working on. It is a template to use for small projects, and it has a lot of the good stuff from Astro 3.0 baked in, including asset optimization, view transitions. It comes out of the box with Tailwind, and I'm using Flowbite UI components to import components that kind of have a cohesion and make sense together. So this is what it looks like here. We got the dark and light mode toggle. It also saves dark and light mode to the memory of the browser. So when you change pages, it's going to remember what the setting is. We got all these different sections. We got all these different pages. And the good news is you can edit all of this information for the most part within a JSON file. So here we have all the project information. We have our social links, which are down in the footer. We have all the pages in the navigation. We have the owner and site name and site description. And then for some of these larger components, like the timeline, they're just right above the component itself. So you just fill in these variables up here with the information that you'd like to render within the component. So it's super simple and easy to get started. This is the index page. Look at how clean everything is and how easy it is to work with. If you want to remove, say you want to remove the top call to action, you can just remove it here and rebuild it. And there we go. If you don't want the featured list, you remove the featured list. There you go. There's also a page for components. So I built a separate page for all the components that I've imported from the Flowbite UI component library. We got alerts, avatars. I'm not going to read through them all, but here they are. Gallery, which is really cool, Jumbotron, tables. Another cool thing with this UI component library is they tie assets to Tailwind classes. So you'll see here on the project screen, I'm just using placeholder images, which is a dashboard. And we're in the dark mode, so it's going to show the dark mode of this specific image. If we go to the light mode, you'll notice that the colors change within the image. And that's true also for this device mockup. So if you want to display a website within an iPhone, you can use this specific component, and you can toggle the light and dark mode depending on which one you want the user to see. Or you could just leave it as one. You don't have to use this. You can just do one image and just remove the hidden class for the dark mode. So if you want to get started, I'll link the repository down below. It's Astro Tailwind Flowbite Template. Kind of a mouthful. I might change the name in the future, but I also added a bunch of stuff to the README. So if you're new to programming, the README is kind of the text documentation that introducts the code, and there's usually quick install instructions. Here I have just a quick guide to get the project running and installed on your machine, changing the content, adding pages, using the component library, changing the site logo, favicon, project images, colors, and some guidelines on contributing. So if you'd like to contribute to this code and make it better, feel free to send me a pull request on a forked copy of this repository, and I will definitely take a look. So let's go through the process of setting up a site. I said I would do this on the last video. So since I'm the site owner, I can't make a fork, but I can make a branch. So let's go ahead and do that. I'm going to create a branch for John Smith. So where I'm going to start first is the site JSON. I've already got some of his information filled out. To show you how it works, let's say that this is his son. We're going to say junior here for all of these things. He's actually a painter. All right. And he doesn't want a project page. We're going to get rid of the project page. So I'm going to just remove it from the navigation. We're going to update the social links, John Smith, update those. We don't need to worry about the project thing since we're not showing any project information. Let's see what we look like right now with localhost 431. John Smith Jr.'s portfolio. So we see that the title updated. We remove the project page. We're going to have to tweak the header to remove this since we don't want the project page. The light and dark mode still works. The view transitions still work. All right. So this header information is in a component called header, believe it or not. And we're going to just remove this button for the project page. And you know what? This doesn't look right. So I'm going to change the button alt to just use button. And I'll clean up the button alt import at the top since we're not using it. So that looks pretty good. And the title we're rendering up here at the top. So the title we can change here. John Smith Jr.'s Painter LLC. There we go. Maybe we don't want to yell. Maybe we don't want the exclamation point. And if you didn't want to use the description, if you wanted to do something different, because the description is going to render in the HTML, the metadata, if you wanted to do something different, feel free to just remove this and put whatever you want. So there we go. Okay, going through the index page next, we have the call to action, which is this section here with the screenshot. Here we're going to change the information. I'm a painter. I'll just key in some information here. Okay, so we're importing images from the assets folder. This is using the Astro 3.0 asset optimization. So we have the dark image and light image. We can actually get rid of one of the images and then just remove the hidden class. That will retain just one image. And then we need an image of house painted. Let's find that. Let's try and find one similar to the size. Let's just use this one here. So we're going to be in the source assets directory. And we'll just name this house. And this is a JPEG. There we go. And it should be responsive out of the box. Yep. So this is a good reason why you'd use a component UI library, is it does all that stuff for us. And Flowbite UI uses Tailwind. So we're using a familiar CSS framework. Okay, the next section is going to be the feature, what I call the feature list. So this is going to be this section here. You could add icons or pictures above each of these things, but I just wanted to keep it bare bones so you could update as you see needed. Let me just key in some words here. And I'm going to just use three. So let me just get rid of this, the bottom three rows. All right. And I kind of want to keep it. I want to remove portfolio. That doesn't seem right for this project. Let's, site name should just be, I think we want the site name up here, and then this would be something different. This would be the header. Title is up here. Painting is our business and business is good. Oh, that's way too long. All right. All right, I'm happy with this section. I'm happy with this section. I'm happy with this section. Maybe we don't want a timeline on the index page. That doesn't really make sense for this application. I think we want a gallery. And I'm not going to fill it in with images, but I think it would be cool to have a gallery because John Smith Jr. would have a gallery. Here's all of the houses that he's painted. And then let's go back to the components and see if we can add one more at the bottom. Maybe we want to do prices in a table. Maybe we'll do that. So what you can do is there is a component called heading. Not header, but heading. And that just standardizes all the headings. And that just uses a heading property. So we could say pricing. And that should render. So this, I'm doing this because it keeps the classes and colors and everything of all the different headings. One thing I do have to add is a bottom margin on the gallery. And then I want to import the table. Table's another one where I'm rendering the table using information above the component. There we go. And let's see, product name. So we want a name of a product, estimated time, and price. So we don't need category. So we have a house painting, we have 2 days, $3,000. And we want to make sure to make some adjustments to the table down below to map the variables to the table rows. this is something, if this could be done cleaner, that would be super helpful. If you have any ideas, send me a pull request and I can look at it. But we do have the table, the pricing table set up on over here. This would be a good time to show you Flowbite UI components. So if I'm missing something and it's not in there, feel free to add it yourself. Like there might be a pricing table block here that we could use. So here's a good example here. I could even, let's add this as a new component. I'll just paste in what they give me. And then in the index page, what I can do is add pricing. And then I'll just change this to pricing. So if I want to just copy and paste what we got, okay, perfect. So there we go. And I'll just change the background colors, which I know we're using stone 100 and we're using slates 800 for the dark. So there are the background changes. Perfect. So yeah, John Smith, he's got a header. He's got a link to the contact page. I'm calling this a call to action, but it's not really a call to action. It's kind of an introductory section. And then we have some information. We have a gallery. We have a pricing. Probably don't need that heading now that this component has a heading. So I'll just go through and remove that real quick. So I don't need that import. So look at how clean the index page is. This is it for the index page. I'm just importing components and putting them inside of the layout and then the main component. And his social links have updated, say John Smith at the end. Contact page, we could put some information here. If you want, you don't have to import components. You can just put in information if it's easier. You could do like say div, some info, my phone. So let's import some data for John Smith. We want his phone number. data.contact.phone. There we go. And let's say text center. So it looks like it makes sense. And I don't like that the text is gray. I want it to just be white and dark mode. Maybe I'll make a proper contact component that has like a map and it has the address of the business and the phone number and the email address. But this is pretty good for a contact page. And then one note on the actual contact form. I'm using the form component here. So this is just a blank form. You can use a service like Formspree to get started with a static site contact form. So I'm going to make a new form called John Smith Jr. And I am going to use Formspree here. So we have to paste these actions within the form. And this is going to be unique to you. So this is not something that you want to send me a pull request on. You could push it to GitHub. It's not like super sensitive information. And let's just ensure that we're using the proper type and name for the fields, email. So let's add name, email, to add name message. Okay, so this should be connected to the Formspree. We can push this and we'll test it in a minute. Yeah, there's the command here. Okay, so I'm pretty happy with the changes that we've made. Let's run through it really quick. The navigation is updated. We removed the project. We updated the navigation name or the site name. We changed the header. We removed the project button and just have the contact button, which is nice. View transitions make this really smooth and nice. We have a section up here that we changed. We changed this information here. We have a gallery that we could fill in with some images of painted houses or something. We have a pricing component, which we added. We didn't have this before, but we added it. It's still got to be gone through and adjusted, but I'm happy with the way it looks. We have the same footer, but we updated the links. So all the social links are updated. This is going to automatically update the bottom with our site name. We have a JavaScript function to update the year. And then we have our navigation updated from the site. We adjusted the contact form to push to Formspree. And of course, all of this is while the light and dark mode still work, the navigation still really smooth. And let's push it and test it out. So here's the changes we made. We made 11 changes. Now let's go through the process of adding a domain. So the first step with adding a domain to a project would be to buy the domain. I use Namecheap and it's worked pretty well for me in the past. So I'll keep using it until they let me down, basically. And let me just log in here. Astro Tailwind Sites. Let's do this one. This is a dollar I'm spending. All right. Let me turn off auto renew. This is $1 order. So we push this code to GitHub. And if I search my code repositories on Vercel, I'm going to see this is my project. We're not going to do the John Smith Jr. House one. Let's just do the default template here. I'm going to deploy the project. And it should automatically see that it's an Astro site and kind of fill in all the build commands and stuff for you. You'll see at the bottom, congratulations, your site's deployed. Here it is. And it's working. All right. So let's go to add domain. So if you can't find it, it's just in the settings and then the domain. We're going to add, what did we buy? Yes. Add that. And we'll use the recommended option to add www. It's going to say that our configuration is invalid, which is normal. We've got to add a few records. So we need to type a record to this value, type a at. Let's go to advanced DNS. We're going to add a new record. This is an a record at. We're going to paste in the IP and click the green check. And we need a CNAME record. The name is www and there's the value. So again, let's add another record. This time a CNAME, www, and we'll paste in what they gave us and click the green check. And this can take a little while to populate. Let's test out our contact form. Here's our contact form. Hey. And we'll get a nice separate page from Formspree saying, thanks, you submitted. You can change this. You just go through their documentation. They walk you through how to make a custom thank you page or to just do an alert or something like that. And let's go to our submissions here. And here we have Bob at AOL. This is also going to forward to my email address. And that's basically it. The project is still showing good on Vercel, but the domain is still not updated, but it is working on the domain that they gave us. So that's it. We built a site start to finish in about 20 minutes. You could probably do it even faster. You can probably automate some tasks with some software. And we have a full working website with multiple pages, view transitions, Tailwind CSS, custom components from Flowbite, deployment on Vercel, custom forms. I really hope this was helpful, and you can find all the links below for this code repo, the preview page. Thanks so much for watching. Let me know if there's anything you'd like to see in a future video, and I'll talk to you soon.